it forces you to have the normative content of the right to water and sanitation as a guide. So when you are planning for water and sanitation, there is a temptation to stick to what the MDG framework tells you to do. If we integrate the human rights to water and sanitation into the way we do business, it will mean that we have to prioritize those who have traditionally been left out because they belong to an ethnic minority, because they speak a different language, because they live in a remote rural area, because they live in a slum. So it changes completely the way that we invest our resources, the way that we prioritize our actions. We special rapporteurs receive complaints from alleged victims of violations of the rights to water and sanitation, and we act on these complaints. We send letters of allegation or urgent appeals to governments and ask them questions on specific questions on the allegations we received, and we enter into a dialogue with the government, and hopefully we draw the government's attention to these issues and to the problems of specific voiceless communities, very often completely destitute and voiceless communities in different countries of the world. So I'm working on a handbook on how to implement the rights to water and sanitation that I want to launch next year in September. And one of the chapters of that very practical handbook will be precisely on accountability, in giving guidance to states on the measures that they have to adopt, the measures that have to be put in place in order to ensure that there are accountability mechanisms for the rights to water and sanitation. Well, the fact that I'm special rapporteur, when I was appointed, I was independent expert. Even some friends of mine told me, oh, don't apply to that mandate because it's too weak. It's an unrecognized right. It's just an independent expert. And what the government's negotiating the resolution had in mind was more of an academic research mandate. So watch out. We are not even sure that you can undertake country missions, that you can even write letters of allegation, etc. So the fact that it is now well-established mandate, I think it's a success. That I moved from being an independent expert to a rapporteur is a success, obviously. The fact that the rights to water and sanitation have been recognized explicitly by the UN General Assembly and then subsequently by the Human Rights Council, it's another success. Does this mean that we should be satisfied and happy and think that these are all huge successes that should allow us to rest? Obviously not, because we can only say that there is true success once everybody on earth, without discrimination, has access to safe, affordable drinking water and sanitation. I'm here at the University of North Carolina in front of the famous old well, and just the fact that I am here and the fact that the university invited me to be here to lecture on the rights to water and sanitation and to promote even more discussion about the right to water and sanitation, I think it's an important element to make students aware of the problems that the world faces. So talking about these situations and these issues with students is, I think, a very important first step to make them realize the issues and raise in them the interest of combating inequalities. That's number one. And number two, it's research. If we had research, solid academic research, showing us that universal targets that governments are aiming at will never be achieved if we don't start now eliminating inequalities, I think this type of research would be powerful to convince governments, to convince negotiators in New York on the need to integrate, to not only promote universal access, but also to accompany this commitment towards universal access with a commitment to eliminate inequalities. And if our vision is to have water and sanitation for all by 2030, we have to take the right steps now. And for governments to take the right steps, I think we need NGOs to push them, we need special rapporteurs, but we also need solid work done by the academia to push them in the right direction.